class, I will be showing you the search options which are available within the Scriptcase grid application. The grid application includes four different types of search possibilities: the quick search, the refined search, the advanced search, as well as the dynamic search, each of which with its own particularities and ways of using them. The refined search is a kind of search where we can see a list of values for each field available in the set. So let's see how it works. I'm currently viewing a grid application which is using the products table, and now within the left hand menu I have the option refined search. Clicking and expanding that, I will have the settings available as well as the option select fields. When I click on this item, it will display only records with those values available within the grid. So I can select here various items of the grid application which I want to use within the search. I can then click the save button, and then within the edit fields tab I can make adjustments. Here I can indicate that there is an increment via range if the value will be displayed, if it is a multi-select, if it will be started as open or not, if there is a see more option, and then we can also arrange the sorting and change the message for empty fields. If I go ahead and click save and then run the grid application again, we can then now see the difference by using the refined search within the grid application. On the left hand side here, we can see that we now have a collapsible searchable element which allows us to simply click on a value and the grid will then be automatically updated. Okay, so let's return back to Scriptcase and talk more about the quick search which is available. The quick search, as its name suggests, is supposed to be a faster way to filter data. It is available on the grid toolbar, so the user is able to search records without leaving the grid application screen. Let's see some options here. Again, within the left-hand menu, we have a dedicated search area, which is where we will find the elements for the quick search and general search settings, as well as the dynamic search. So here we can click on settings, and we can specify within the settings whether the search criteria will be an and or an or. We can also display the condition and also use autocomplete in the fields. Okay, so let's select the quick search, and there we also have a settings option available. Here I can define if the search button will be in the text area of the box. We can define a watermark to be included, as well as the quick search width and the option to search anywhere. So I will leave these as the default options right now. And below the settings option, we have the select fields. Now here we can select which fields the quick search will use to search. So we could essentially remove many of these and only have the quick search used to search relevant fields within the grid application. The next search is the advanced search. This search is different from all the others because we have a whole new application that is used with the grid. So let's start with the general setting. Selecting the advanced search, we can then view the settings that are available. Here you can define typical options as the alignments and margins of the application. The keep values allows to maintain the searched values when the user returns to the search form. Let's set the enter key action to submit the search form. And then below that, we also have the display tags, which allows to display the grid, the searched values in a tags format. Let's have a look at that by running our grid application, accessing the grid, and then selecting the search button available in the header. Now here we can then provide our search variables or elements that we want to search for, and we have then the option to save filter. I will now use the product name search field, and I will search for coffee, for instance, and there I have some automatic suggestions. Now, if I go ahead and click the search button, within the grid at the top, we can now see that we have tags available for the searched item. Let's return back to Scriptcase and continue with the search settings. Within the search settings, we can also select fields that will be available in the search, and we can define if they will be required or not. Below settings, we have the select fields option, and there we can adjust the fields which will be included within the search form. We can also define the buttons which will be available within the toolbar by selecting the toolbar option within the left menu. Here we can then adjust the layout of the buttons for the search application. Below that, we can use inline buttons, as well as configure various button settings, such as the button labels, as well as the inline position and column quantity. We can also apply hotkeys to the search application individually, as well as to the grid, and defining hotkey bindings and binding that hotkey to a specific action can be also applied quite easily by clicking the plus button, selecting the action, and then providing a key binding. Back to the left-hand menu and below the toolbar, we also have the option to save search, which allows us to enable the save feature within the form. Here we can enable this for public and also apply rules. Accessing that within the search form, we can see that there is the save filter button, which allows us then to save filters for specific search actions. Returning back to Scriptcase and below the save search, we can see that we also have four events available: on script init, on refresh, on save, and on validate. The search events do not have any relationship with the grid events, so the validations you apply here will only affect the advanced search. Accessing one of the events, we have the typical code editor available, which is where we can call local and global variables, JavaScript code, CSS code, as well as the available Scriptcase macros. The next search available is the dynamic search. Selecting dynamic search will provide the settings, which is where we can then specify if the enter key will be used and what it will be used for. And below the settings, we can then specify the fields, which are then available for the dynamic search. So in this case, the developer needs to indicate which fields will be available. Then you can configure the field settings the same way we had done with the advanced search. If I go ahead and add some fields, save that, and run the form again, now back to the grid, and accessing the search button, we can see next to it that we now have the dynamic search available. Clicking that will expand the options, and then we can add the specific fields which we want to use and also configure the values. Thank you for watching this part of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. I hope to see you again soon in the next class.